what the president is asking for or not. Joining me now, CNN intelligence and security analyst Bob Baer and criminal defense attorney Caroline Polisi. Caroline, I want to start with you here. Let's just take a step back. The president is not asking, he is demanding that the Department of Justice investigate an investigation of him.
Right, and he sounds more like a dictator than the leader of a democratic nation in that tweet, John. Now, the legal issue is the constitutionality of this demand. And he is correct in the sense that the Justice Department does fall within the executive branch, obviously. But there is longstanding historical precedent in this country that, the Oval Office and the Department of Justice stay in their separate lanes. And we haven't seen anything like this. I mean, really approaching it since Nixon. And it's just amazing and it's unprecedented.
And in the past, when we have seen it, we have seen reaction from those inside the Department of Justice who have refused to comply,
right,
up to a point, or
which
quit.
I think, I think Rosenstein's, response was measured in being conciliatory on one point, but also not, inciting a showdown.
We'll talk about that much more in a second. Bob Baer, I want to ask here, and again, it is not as if there has been evidence of this, but what's the difference between a spy and an infiltrator, which is the language that Rudy Giuliani, the president, and his allies are using? What's the difference between that and a source or an informant?
Well, I mean, look, first of all, Giuliani and the president are being disingenuous about this, John. The FBI, when it got a lead that Carter Page was possibly a Russian agent, at that point was legally obligated to open an investigation, which included putting a tap on his phone, on his cell phone, and also running a confidential informant into Carter Page and a couple other suspect Russian moles. This is what the FBI does. But I guarantee you the president, President Obama, did not call up the FBI and say, open up a political investigation into Donald Trump. It just did not happen. So he's conflating these two things, a counterintelligence investigation and a political, dirty tricks.
And again, Rod Rosenstein, in his statement where he said the inspector general was going to look into this, he said if anyone did infiltrate or surveil participants in a presidential campaign for inappropriate purposes, we need to know about it. That phrase, inappropriate purposes, Bob, again, is there any public evidence this was for inappropriate purposes?
Well, no, it's exactly like when Trump said my phones at Trump Tower were tapped. He said, I know that for a fact. And as it turned out, that did not turn out to be true. You have a president that truly believes there is such a thing as a deep state. The FBI is at the center of the deep state and is out to get him. There simply has been no evidence brought forth to support that. There is no deep state, of course, John, but what can you do?
Exactly. Caroline, the question now is, did the Deputy Attorney General defuse this by putting this in the Inspector General's lap, or is it sort of a tacit affirmation that there is a question of impropriety here, or I guess option C is both?
I think a little bit of both. Look, Rod Rosenstein has stated publicly before that the Justice Department will not be extorted. So I think he has a fine line to play whether or not this is going to be sort of a showdown of constitutional proportions, or whether or not he can kind of, conciliate to the president by saying, look, the IG inspector in general is already, conducting this investigation. Yeah, let's throw this in there a little to include that in the ambit. Obviously, if there was impropriety, at afoot, they would want to know about it. So that's kind of a throwaway statement. I mean, it's like saying, we are concerned about crime being committed. So, I think he's towing the line here. He's between a rock and a hard place. He doesn't want to lose his job, but he's not going to be a yes man.
He's just trying to push this off as long as he can. I'm not sure it's even about his job. I think he wants to push off a confrontation because of the possible implications it can have long term there. Bob Baer, this source, right, this confidential source that was used by the FBI has already been identified in some outlets. How dangerous is it to have the identity of someone like this made public? Because it has, in a sense, been forced by people in Congress, among others.
Yeah, exactly. He's undermining the FBI, Trump is. And if you start exposing sources for whatever reason, you start down a path of destroying the FBI. And what's next? Chris Steele, the guy that wrote the dirty dossier, he had Russian sources, which the FBI knows. Why not ask who those Russian sources are? And if those Russian sources are in Russia, they will be assassinated or put in jail. You don't want to go there, but they apparently are going to try.
And Bob, just very quickly, institutionally speaking, are you glad the deputy AG is saying this will be investigated, or do you wish he had just shut it down completely?
No, it's fine. You know, you go to Horowitz, the IG, the Inspector General, and you say, look into this. He comes out with the facts, and then I hope this all goes away once he presents them to Congress and the president.
Caroline, let me ask you about